They say it's wrong. They say it's dirty. They say it's bad to talk about sex. The truth is, all of us have a sexual side, so it shouldn't be avoided, treated as something dirty, or something to be afraid of. The key is to have the right perspective about sex and its role in our lives. Sex is an important part of our lives. Without it, no one would be here. In the right light, sex is not vulgar or dirty, but a beautiful expression of emotions, attraction, and commitment. When sex is done with respect for oneself and partner or spouse, an open mind and a sense of responsibility, there's no reason for sex to be seen as something immoral, bad, or taboo. Responsible sex is helpful in keeping a relationship healthy, especially between husband and wife. It can also keep one's outlook in life positive and may even help in one's physical health. Responsible sex is a good way to keep oneself healthy, physically, mentally, socially, and emotionally. Responsible sex can lead to a healthy life. However, sex done in an irresponsible manner can lead to consequences that lead to all the taboo things that people usually think of when talking about sex. Early and unplanned pregnancies and contracting sexually transmitted infections or STIs are just some of the negative consequences of irresponsible and reckless sex. One sexually transmitted infection that is easily passed from one person to another is HIV. HIV is short for human immunodeficiency virus. This is the virus that attacks the body's immune system, making the body weak and vulnerable to a number of other infections and diseases. HIV also leads to AIDS, or acquired immune deficiency syndrome. AIDS is a combination of signs and symptoms that result from a person's immune system's inability to defend itself from illnesses. However, it takes years for an HIV-infected person to show signs and symptoms of AIDS. An HIV-positive person is different from a person who is clinically diagnosed to have AIDS. The problem with HIV is that it is quite easy to get infected. For one, HIV-positive people look as healthy as everyone else. They don't show any symptoms, or they may not even experience any symptom. As such, an HIV-positive person may not even know that he or she has contracted the virus. Without any telltale signs of the infection, it is easy to feel that there is nothing wrong and indulge in sexual activities that puts you at risk for HIV infection. HIV can be contracted through unprotected sex with an HIV-positive person, blood infected with HIV via transfusions or instruments contaminated with HIV, pregnant HIV-positive women who transmit the virus to their unborn children. It's a common misconception that HIV can be transmitted via tears, sweat, or saliva. Only blood, semen, and vaginal fluids can transmit HIV. While HIV is a real threat and danger to one's life, it doesn't mean one is powerless to protect oneself and his or her partner from being infected. The most effective way to protect and prevent an HIV infection is to abstain from having sex. HIV infection can also be prevented by having only one sexual partner. Remember that this only works if your partner also practices having only you as a sexual partner. If having multiple sex partners cannot be avoided, then safe sex should be practiced. Use a condom correctly and consistently. No other form of contraception can help prevent HIV or AIDS. The best way to be sure about your sexual health is to take an HIV antibody test. There are medical centers and social clinics that can help you understand and find out your sexual health status in a completely confidential manner. Best of all, these centers also provide counseling so you can fully grasp the topic from a physical, emotional, and social perspective. When you know your own sexual health status, you feel secure that you are healthy and not a source of infection to your partner. An HIV antibody test is available in most hospitals, medical centers, and social hygiene clinics. These centers are equipped with the necessary tools and training to help you understand and cope with your needs. Most importantly, these centers are trained to keep all information about everyone strictly confidential. Most people don't go for testing because of their fears of the test and the results. That is why these centers provide counseling before taking an HIV antibody test. Undergoing counseling before taking the HIV antibody test will give you a broad view of the purpose of the test, what diseases should be tested, when to have it, and if there are window periods, the procedure itself, what the results mean, when the results will be released, as well as primary information on HIV and AIDS. Remember that the test is strictly confidential and that you have the right to demand for confidentiality. After the test, there are also enough resources provided to help you cope with the results, whether they turn up positive or negative. Everyone who takes the HIV antibody test will also undergo counseling after taking the test, whatever the results may be. For those whose results came up negative, information on HIV and AIDS will be provided, as well as ways to get more information and/or referrals. For those whose HIV antibody test results are positive, emotional support and other forms of assistance are provided, such as informational guides on how to cope and live with the disease. After all, a positive result does not mean the end of the world. With proper medication and a vigilant health perspective, an HIV-infected person can still live a full life. Sex is part of a normal life. With the right perspective, it can be celebrated and enjoyed, rather than treated as something dirty and taboo. What's important is that this is done between people who are responsible, committed, and do it out of love. For more information, you can visit or call any of these centers.